Hey guys, today I'm going to show you how to watch any video at any frame rate. I've tested this on a 144 FPS monitor, 144Hz monitor, but I don't know if it goes higher. So you can let me know if this works for you in the comment section below. So the first thing you want to do is open up a browser. I'm using Google Chrome and just type in SVP download. That's the software we're going to use. It's called Smooth Video Project SVP, and it is to increase the frame rate of videos and also watch online YouTube videos with SVP, which makes your YouTube videos work in 144 FPS as well if you want to do that. I'm going to use a free version, which is SVP for free, and that works on Windows. This is for Windows, the default one, as you can see, operating system Windows. So you want to click download. I'll have the link in the description. What you want to do is download the file and save it, and once you've downloaded it and saved it, just run the file. So I'm going to go and do that right now. So this is the file that I've downloaded. As you can see, it says SVP for free online. That's the file that should have downloaded. Once it's downloaded, just double click it and run it, or you could just run it as soon as you download it, but I'm just going to run it. As you can see, it says SVP for free setup wizard, which is the setup wizard for the free version of SVP. Just click next, and you can choose where you want SVP to be installed. I'm just going to do it as the default directory. This is to set up SVP, so you use SVP with these video players. I have a 64-bit PC, so I'm going to do 64-bit as well, and yeah, so I can use 64-bit versions of the MPCHC. So you do need a specific video player for this, but it would install it afterwards. So as you can see, I want the MPCHC video player, which is what is going to install if you tick this box. And you don't have to have that. If you don't tick this box, then it won't install it. But I'm going to tick this box so I can install the video player with it, which is, I think this is the best player that comes with it. So I'm just going to just leave it and install that as well. Okay, you can leave these how it is, but if you don't want it to be your default video player, just uncheck that. So I'm just going to click next, and I click accept the license, and next, and just next, and click install. And then as you can see, it'll come up with a user account control, and just click yes so that you allow the permissions, and it's just going to download it and install it. After that is nearly done, it will show you this box if you checked the install MPCHC, and I did. So this is going to install MPCHC, the media player that comes with it, and I'm just going to do the default settings. It should be fine, all the default settings are all right. Just install, and it will install that. You don't want to launch it, it's fine. You don't have to tick anything there. And as you can see, it's just going to finish up the installation now. And yeah, you can click run SVP for free now. So once that's done, it's going to run the SVP. So it wants to assess the system performance. So you want to close any applications that use performance, including the web browser. But I'm going to keep the web browser open just to show you how this works. Obviously, I'm recording right now as well, so. And once that's done, it'll just close and everything should be fine. So you're ready to use the SVP. It's going to show up in the hidden icons in your taskbar. It's going to show up there. Just click the up arrow and you'll see it. And this is the default settings that it gave to me. So yeah, as you can see, there you go. And first thing you want to do when you open this, you want to click the three dots in the top right, and then obviously it would come up with application settings, and you want to click application settings, and as you can see, you want to go scroll down until you find max underneath FRC, and what you want to change that to is your monitor's refresh rate. So I'm going to change that to 144 because my monitor refreshes at 144 FPS. So what this does is it allows videos up to 144 FPS to be played at 144 FPS. So any video under 144 FPS will automatically be interpolated to 144 FPS. Now I'm just going to run a video just to test it out, and I'm just going to drag a video file into it, and I'm going to show you that this works. So as you can see, it won't show anything, but now it says SVP playing at 144.937. So it's actually playing at 144 FPS right now, even though the video is not 144 FPS. Yeah, it's working. But if you want to watch YouTube videos at 144 FPS, on the original download page, you're going to want to need to download SVP Tube. So as you can see, it says SVP Tube. And so you want to download the file. As you can see, I'm going to save it. And it says SVP Tube 1.27 zip. This is to watch YouTube videos at 144 FPS. So you want to extract this folder to SVP Tube obviously, and as you can see, it's a separate application. But what you can do, if you don't want it to be like separated, you can put it in the folder of SVPs. So I'm just going to do that. So SVP, and I'm going to open file location, and it's a shortcut, so I'm going to open file location again, and this is the directory of SVP4, so C program files SVP4, and I'm just going to put SVPTube in there just to make it all in one place. As you can see, it's right there. And what you want to do is create a shortcut on your desktop if you want to keep that on, because you need to run this before you open any YouTube video. But I'm not going to put the shortcut on the desktop just yet. So you just want to click run. You just want to run the exe file. It doesn't have to be in your SVP4 folder, but I decided to do that. And it's going to wait for you to copy a YouTube video. So I'm going to go over to my channel. So let's try this shaders video from Minecraft that I did ages ago. So I'm just going to copy link address, which is basically the YouTube link, and this will just open up straight away. And this video was definitely 30 FPS because of I couldn't even run this at 60 FPS, but as you can see, it is playing at 144 FPS. The video is much smoother than it is on actual YouTube. And if it doesn't work very well, you can just go change that to higher performance, which makes the video run smoother, hopefully. Obviously, there'll be slightly more artifacts, which is the issue with putting on higher performance, but it does look slightly smoother. It's just there's a bit of glitches. So obviously, you can change the slider to suit how you want to suit it. Okay, so this video it's got my old intro in it, and it's not 60 FPS, so let's copy that. Let's see how that comes out. Oh, that looks nice. So much better than 30 FPS. And obviously it's still streaming from the internet, so it does sometimes buffer. And obviously the performance is not as good because I'm recording, but that's how you do it. Please leave a like if this tutorial helped you. Please subscribe for more tutorials like this one. And maybe I'll teach you how to actually save a video in 144 Hz or 144 FPS or 60 FPS if you want that. That might require the paid version of this software, so I'm not sure. So we'll see. But yeah, that's the end of the tutorial. Please leave a like if this helps you and subscribe for more, and I'll see you guys on the next video. Also comment down below if this worked for you. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video. Goodbye.